In the previous video, we started the discussion on Venn diagrams and worked on this example in which we had a universal set along with two subsets that did not have any element in common. Now let's make some change to the problem to see what happens if A and B do have some common elements. Let's say set B also has the elements 5 and 7. With this change, A and B now have two elements in common. And this should reflect in the Venn diagram. Common elements mean common region, which implies an overlap between the two circles. So, our new Venn diagram would look something like this. As you can see, this time the two circles representing A and B intersect. We now need to populate it with elements. Again, we begin with the innermost region, the region of overlap between A and B. 5 and 7 are the elements that are common to both the sets, and so we put 5 and 7 in that region. Then, we see what is still missing from A, and we put that in the outer region of A. So, 1 and 2 go there. We do the same thing with B, and so we put 8 and 9 in the relevant region. Now we move to the outermost region. So far, the rectangle has already got 1, 2, 5, 7, 8, and 9. So what we need to add is 3, 4, and 6. And so we list these elements. This completes our Venn diagram. Okay, let us now draw the Venn diagram for this problem. Here, as always, A and B are both subsets of the universal set, but the important point is that B is a subset of A too. Everything that B has is also in A. So in the Venn diagram, the entire circular region of B will be inside the circle of set A. Here's the Venn diagram. Now that you've got a basic understanding of the Venn diagrams, let us quickly look at what the different regions in a Venn diagram mean. Focus on the shaded regions, please. We already know that this rectangular region represents the universal set. This circular region represents the set A. And this circular region represents the set B. What does this region represent? It should not be difficult to see that we have a sum of the two regions, the circular regions that belong to sets A and B. Or in the language of set theory, we have A union B. This region contains all the elements that are in either or both of A and B. Alright, here the shaded region is the region that is common to both A and B, or in the language of sets, A intersection B. This region is the entire universal set except the region that also belongs to set A. So, there's nothing but U minus A. We also call it A complement. This region contains all the elements that are in U but not in B. So, there's U minus B or B complement. This is the region of set A except the part that also belongs to B. So, A minus B. It contains all the elements that are in A but not in B. Similarly, this is B minus A. Okay, so that was about the different regions. The next video covers the Venn diagrams for a system of three sets and a universal set. Thank you.